Governor, let's get right to it. Why announce a phase zero if we're not ready to get into phase one just yet?
Well, I think it's important that my constituency, that all Nevadans know where we're at. Right now, we're at a little over 4,000 positive cases, I think 174 fatalities. That could have been many times that had we not taken the action we did when we did it. And I'm proud that Nevada has stepped up and has implemented the social distancing rule, the large group gathering rule, the hygiene rules. They've been great about that. And we're getting closer. We're not quite there yet. You know, we're at a plateau and hopefully we're on our way down, and the statistics are going to tell us when we're ready.
The question was asked yesterday. Businesses are aching to reopen. They're aching to tell their landlords why they can't pay rent this month. They're aching for some sort of date. Even if it wasn't achievable, why not a date for phase one?
Well, I think to pick a date out of the air, just for the sake of picking a date, would be a disservice to everyone and be disingenuous. The date is going to be determined by the virus and the way that we continue to comply with the directives that were previously issued. You know, the more we have social distancing and small gatherings and avoid these large gatherings, the better our numbers are going to look, the less positives we're going to have, the less people we're going to have in ICU units or on ventilators. And then we'll be able to proceed to the first phase, which would be opening up some of the businesses. But it's not a date. It's a statistic that gets us to when we're going to be ready to go. And while we're making progress, I don't feel it'd be fair to everybody to just pick an arbitrary date and then to kind of be stuck with it, yes or no.
Do you, I know your office and Dieter have been working to process the avalanche of claims. We're still getting the calls, and then independent contractors will essentially have possibly had no income for 2 months. Is there any way to add more employees, spur the process for independent contractors? Because right now, a lot of people are still left hanging.
You're right. They are left hanging. And in every one of those that are left hanging, I feel terrible for. Like I say, when I was very young, my father went through having to go on unemployment. I know it's a difficult situation. I know that people count on the money. That being said, we're doing everything we can. There are about 5% of the claims. I understand that you're getting calls about, you know, people that are frustrated getting through. But you have to understand that we have processed 350,000 claims in the last 4 weeks. I mean, the vast majority of people are getting through, and we're doing everything we can to make sure that we handle every single person that's calling in and asking for help. But it's a manpower issue. We've never been stressed, our facility, you know, our structure to this extent to handle this number of claims, but we're working on it and working to get to every single one of them.
Is there any efforts to maybe add even more employees, maybe make phone lines 7 days a week? Is there any talks of strategies on that realm?
We are working on that with Dieter to work on whether we can expand the hours, expand the shifts, all those sort of things. Understand, the folks that are there are doing an incredible job. They are. It's just that they are overwhelmed with casework, and we're doing whatever we can to help them to function as effectively and efficiently as possible. And I ask people to bear with me. I know I'm asking a lot. I know it requires a lot of sacrifice and a lot of patience, but you're not forgotten, and we're doing everything we can to get to every single person.
What'd you think about Mayor Carolyn Goodman's interview with Anderson Cooper today and then CNBC?
I saw the Anderson Cooper interview. I can tell you this. I spent 10 years before I became governor on the Clark County Commission. 6 years I was chair of the Clark County Commission. And the Strip falls under the jurisdiction of the Clark County Commission and Chair Marilyn Kirkpatrick. And we've got a lot of leaders in Southern Nevada that are very participatory in the decisions. I mean, Mayor March and Henderson and the Clark County Commission and some of the other city councils. It's my job to represent the whole state and Clark County, and I care tremendously about all of our Nevadans and all our visitors, but I don't think it's reasonable that a person should have to choose between getting a paycheck and keeping their job and trying to keep their life. That's an unfair choice to give people. We want to be a safe destination, but this isn't something that can be done haphazardly. We're doing this based on statistics, based on advice from medical professionals. I certainly do not want to use the citizens or the employees of Southern Nevada as a control group or as a placebo as was said. It's my job to help protect all of the citizens in Clark County, and I just think that we want everybody back. We want all our tourists back. Las Vegas is a great place to come. It's a great place to party and have a great time. We want you all to come back, but not today or tomorrow.
If the mayor was in the room right now, what would you say to her?
I would say, Mayor, I wish you would, you know, look at the statistics a little bit more and understand that we're trying to do what's best. I can't use Las Vegas as an experiment, and I'm committed to doing this the right way. And I know the mayor had problems when I shut down the Strip, and she was not pleased about that. But I certainly support the idea of opening up and welcoming everybody back when the time is right. That time is just not now, and that time is not an arbitrary date. That is going to be based on the numbers that we get forward from our cases, our hospital usage, and whether or not the hospitals are going to be able to handle a surge of patients.
In your phase one, there's a lot of businesses that weren't mentioned, maybe some retail clothing stores, maybe salons, nail salons, massage services. There's a lot of services that weren't addressed. Have those come on your table for a phase one?
We are looking at all of the businesses, and this can be done through Michael Brown, who's the director of the Governor's Office of Economic Development, now Governor's Office of Economic Recovery. I had a governor's call, national governor's call this morning for about an hour, and we all talked. And I don't know how you can do some of those businesses and have social distancing. I don't know how you get a massage and stay 6 feet away from someone, or how you cut someone's hair and stay 6 feet away. My wife cut my hair because we live in the same household, but that you don't need the 6 foot distance separation in that case. We're going to analyze the businesses on a case-by-case basis. Hopefully, we'll be able to allow a little bit more curbside delivery and opening and so forth. But this has to be done in a gradual and methodical manner so that you see if a change that we have made causes a spike in the cases or in the hospitalizations, and then you could roll that back a little bit. It's important. We've made the citizens of the state of Nevada have been incredible. I mean, they have followed up the request. They've done, like I say, the social distancing. They're wearing face coverings. I don't want 6 weeks of great effort that everybody's put forth to go to waste because I was a week over anxious and it opened something up. That just would not be reasonable for me to do. So it's important to me that we do this, but we do it right, because we're only going to get one chance to do it right.
A lot of the small businesses with the Small Business Administration, as we famously know, the funds have dried up and there's a lot of small businesses in Nevada hurting. Is there anything you're doing in terms of working with our federal partners to try to see what else we can get for Nevada small businesses?
We had an all-hands-on conference call with our federal delegation. There are four Congress members and two senators yesterday and talked about this very issue. They're fighting on the national level to get more money into Nevada to help our small businesses and help them open up. And we want to do that as well, any way that we possibly can. It's a difficult situation. They had to close down relatively quickly. And, you know, I know that they've got life savings poured into a small business and want to do everything we can to make them successful. But it's important that we do it the right way. It's important for their long-term success that we do it the right way, to have it open up and have their particular business turn into a hotspot, or be a, you know, have someone in there that's a carrier, a super spreader, would not be a good thing for anybody. So we're very cautious about that, and we're going to open it up in a very methodical sense that, you know, we're going to slowly allow for more interaction, but it's going to be important that you maintain some of the same restrictions that we put in place, the social distancing, the facial coverings, the hygiene, so forth and so on.
Is there anything being done in terms of evictions? After the emergency stay is lifted, a lot of businesses have been out of business for close to 2 months and might not be able to pay their rent, and people too. Is there anything being done to look at what's next after the emergency declaration is lifted?
That's something that falls under the Attorney General's realm. I mean, we speak with him on a regular basis. He's asked if people have specific cases that they need help with, that they can call his office. I encourage all of you folks to do that. If they have a specific case, we put instructions out there. Hopefully landlords are complying with them. And it doesn't do a landlord any good to evict a business and try to bring somebody else in at a time like this. You know, hopefully the landlords will work with the various businesses and they'll all be successful in the long run.
Is there anything I didn't ask that you wanted to communicate to the people of Clark County tonight?
Yeah, I would just like to say thank you for participating, for doing everything you can to help slow the spread and flatten the curve. It's making a difference. It's definitely making a difference. I know that people are getting a little frustrated or cabin fever, whatever it might be, staying inside and being confined to an indoor setting. But it's working. It's definitely working. And you see the result with, like I say, 174 deaths and 4,000 cases. It would have been an exponential number of that had we not done this. I mean, the predictions that were made early on were tens of thousands of deaths we could have had and, 100,000 cases. And we're doing everything we can. And I think when you compare us to other states, you see that our numbers are relatively good. Or they're good. They're not relatively good. They're good. And we need to continue to keep them that way and make sure that as we roll out, we don't undo all of the good that we've done previously. And I just want to ask folks to hang in there just a little bit longer and to say thank you for being participatory in this situation and helping to slow the spread and to keep people safe.
Thank you, Governor, for your time.
Thanks a lot.